是一兆两兆的兆，是一兆很成万里的很成万里的很兆文老先生，他是我们中国的茶叶方面的专家，就是说对中国的茶咯，无论是黑茶也好，红茶也好，普洱茶也好，绿茶也好，白茶也好，啊，
黄茶也好，
还有黄茶也好。 都非常熟悉的，也知道这些茶产于哪些地方，还有哪些根因。对茶道来讲的话呢，也非常比较权威。就是我们今天就请这位老先生跟大家讲，大家欢迎。So
that Master Ming Chan introduced our speaker today. Who is Professor Shi Zhaopeng, who is China's leading academic expert on tea, on all aspects of tea, the difference of growing and processing green tea, white tea, oolong tea, black tea, pu'er tea, etc., and also on different aspects of Chinese tea ceremony.
所以我们这一位就不要介绍他了，这一位就是湖南黑茶最大的一个产地，叫做白沙溪，白沙溪上的老总，在我们西文叫总裁，也是高级茶艺师，叫刘兴安先生。This
is Mr. Liu Xingan, who is the director and owner of Hunan's largest. Black tea processing plant, who I think also produced our bricks there.
This is, in our Hunan, the process of the tea, the production, the sale, this kind of expert. 就是行政委先生。
This is Mr. Xin Zhiwei, who is one of Hunan's biggest experts in picking original tea materials for production. So it's like you, when you before you produce something, you need to go to the market and pick and choose. So he, in tasting the different types of tea, he's one of the best ones they have in the province.
这又是萧一平先生，他是黑茶的，就是说，家传制作人吧。包括我们刘兴安先生，这是一代一代传的下来，现在是第四一代了，还是第几代啊？第四一代了吧？哎，第四一代的就是黑茶制作权。这是高级茶艺师。This is Mr. Xiao Yiping, who is the person
who is in charge or is one of Hunan's main expert in fermenting and producing the tea, which is actually, you know, like those are things that go into company secrets. And he is the 11th lineage holder in a long line of people who have learned this trade. So this is Mr. Ho, who is a designer. He's advertising and design. He is also the person who designed the packaging for our bag.
You
don't need to. Good morning, everybody.
Today, this is a good opportunity.
I'm very excited to be with you out here in nature today with so many people from different countries around the world to taste and discuss tea, which is always something that brings people together. I would like to talk about four aspects of tea first.
一个问题是茶叶的起源的问题。
The first issue I want to discuss is, since when do we have tea? What is the history of tea?
第二个问题是中国茶叶以及世界茶叶这个分类的问题。
The second thing is the different kinds of tea that we have in China and around the world.
第三个问题呢，是向大家介绍一下品茶、品茶跟喝茶。
So the next thing I want to discuss is the grading of different teas, the tasting of different teas, and the drinking of different teas.
第四个问题就是谈一下那个茶叶的一些功效。
The fourth topic I would like to talk about is to discuss tea from a medicinal perspective. What are the medicinal properties of tea?
我首先谈第一个问题，这个茶叶的起源。
The first one, first topic, history of tea. Since when does tea exist?
茶叶起源于我国，大概五千年来，有五千年的历史。
According to what the experts agree upon is that tea in China has a 5,000 year history.
那是神农时候。 神能是我们古代的一个部族的首领。So
it really starts in the mythological times of China, at the time of the Shennong Emperor, the divine husbandman, who was probably at some point as a historical figure, a tribal leader.
一些植物性的食物都是由神能 三百草而得出来的。
According to legend, Shennong was the emperor who taught humanity farming and about herbs and about the different flavors of food.
有一天，他三百草的时候，他中了毒，中了毒，做了一株树下面。 昏迷的时候，顺手摘了一批叶片，放在嘴里嚼一嚼，一嚼以后，感觉人就舒服了，这个就是茶。<laughs> One
time when he was walking in nature to go about his business of tasting the 100 flavors, he picked a leaf and put it in his mouth, according to legend, so the story goes, and immediately felt incredibly comfortable and light. And that was the beginning of drinking tea in China.
So,
So later, because we know that in Chinese medicine, very often the advice is given, while you drink the herbs, you shouldn't be drinking tea at the same time. It's because it has a detoxifying or neutralizing effect. And so Shen Nong, in his, as being the first scientist exploring the 10,000 poisons, he would meet, there was this later report that he met with 72 poisons every day, and he used the tea to detoxify himself from the negative effect of the poisons.
So now, 还是把茶在民间当成一种药来使用.
So all the way until present day, you treat tea in the general populace in the countryside as a folk medicine.
在药食藤原的一个国度里面，我们讲茶在以前是药。 但是现在我们并不把茶当成药，而是把茶当成饮料。
In modern times, we treat tea as a leisure drink, whereas once again, he wants to emphasize that in ancient times, it was primarily a medicine.
福建在徐谈的时候传入到我们中国，从那个时候起。 从唐朝的时候起，茶叶就已经成为我们国家的饮料了，就不当药了。但是，在我们历史的记载里面，还是有很多区都把茶当成一项草药。So
since the Tang Dynasty, when China's borders increased, to also include what is called Fujian Province nowadays, where of course a lot of the famous tea production comes from in China. So approximately 8th century or so, or 7th century, at that time, tea was treasured as a leisure drink that you would enjoy every day, but nevertheless, its medicinal qualities got still being used as that in among the general populace.
唐朝有一个医学家叫做陈传器，陈传，西藏的传，器器具的器。陈传器他讲，国药，居药为国片之药，茶。 为万病之药，居药为国病之药，茶为万病之药。
During that time, during the Tang Dynasty, was a famous tea expert called Chen Chuanqi, who said that the tea is the remedy for all 10,000 diseases, meaning you can use it for almost everything.
当然，这个似乎什么一个万病之药是不可能，但是仙明茶叶，由于它里面含了很多多酚类，这个强剂很多，还有很多的这个其他的这种治病的这种成分。 所以它有这有一些药性是的确的。后来 我们国家把它整洁茶可以治24种疾病。
Well, we probably cannot say that tea is a cure for all disease. From a biochemical perspective, tea is certainly one of the richest substances in the plant world, and therefore has a very broad spectrum of bioavailable materials. When the government of the People's Republic of China tried to classify what kind of diseases can be treated with tea, they still counted 24 different classes of disease that can be treated with tea.
称唐盛的时候，我们国家的茶，这个摘茶、制茶的方、饮茶的方法，就传到日本去了。
It was during the Tang and Song Dynasty, approximately from the 7th to the 12th century, that the way of tea, the way of cultivating tea, harvesting tea, and drinking tea, that whole culture got exported to Japan.Where it then took root and developed further on its own.
我们嘉山寺就是在宋朝的时候，日本的朋友到这来学佛，然后把茶带到了日本。茶山一味，山茶一味，就是那个时候出去的。
One important place actually where tea was exported from China to Japan was right here at the Jiashan Temple, which was of course the birthplace of Japanese Zen. And there is up to the present day still the spring that you can see, the water of which you would use toboil the tea and make, because the tea is not just the substance of the leaves, but also the quality of the water is very important. So that calligraphy in Kyoto, that is also in our booklet, Chan Cha Yi Wei, which means the number one flavor, the top Zen tea, that comes from here.
这是第一个问题，第二个问题呢，就是中国茶叶的分类。
About the second topic, the different kinds of tea that we have in China.
中国茶叶分六大类。
There's six different types of tea in China.
红茶、绿茶、黑茶。黄茶、青茶、白茶、红茶。
对，红茶 red tea。
绿茶。
绿茶 green tea。
黑茶
black tea。
No. Black tea 是红茶。
哦，那么黑茶呢？
Dragon tea。
那么
黑茶呢？因为红茶外形是黑的，
对，
所以外国的朋友就把那个 black tea 印在那 red tea 上面去了，一次错到现在，我们纠正已经来不及了。
那么那个黑茶怎么翻译呢？假如是红茶是 black tea， 那么黑茶是什么呢？
Black tea.
So he said there has been this translation mistake for several hundred years, because what they call Hong Cha red tea, direct literal translation red tea, that is actually what we call black tea. But then they also have a Hei Cha, which is really means black tea literal, but I'm asking him what Dr. Liu said black tea, real black tea. What is the difference? We don't know.
现在我们湖南省 六大茶都有，这个是世界各国都没有的，只有我们中国有这个六大类茶。
六大类茶，红茶、黑茶、
红茶、黄茶、白茶、
青，就是乌龙。
黄
茶、
黑茶、
白茶。
So once again, the six groups of tea are the red tea that we normally consider the black tea in the West. Then there is the 绿茶, the green tea. Then there's the 黑茶that we've been drinking here in Hunan, which literally means black tea. Then we've got the 黄茶, yellow tea. We've got 白茶, white tea. And then we've got something that's called 青茶, which means 三件水那个青还是
青。青，色彩的青，
青
颜
色
青，哦，青，对，那个是乌龙茶吗？
乌龙
茶。So 青茶 is another kind of word for green, and that would be what we call 乌龙 tea is one of that kind.
整个茶叶的品种，在中国有1000种以上。
In China, there's more than 1,000 different types of tea.
我搞茶叶搞了50来年，但是我还有的茶叶，我名字我还没听过。
I've been involved in the tea academic research of tea for over 50 years, but there's still some teas out there where I haven't even heard the name of them yet.
这是第简单讲的第二个问题。第三个问题呢，就是谈一下品茶与喝茶。
The third topic, 品茶，那评就是那个批评的评，评价的评。
评价的评。
Yeah, so evaluating tea, grading tea.And then 品茶，品茶。
品就是细的品。
那我知道，但是怎么去翻？是品尝 ，OK。Tasting the tea, and 喝茶 ，drinking the tea。
在福告诉我们，有楼根、楼层。楼石，这个十八界来认识我们这个世界。
So, in Buddhism, we have the concept of the six roots, the six types of dust, and the six types of knowledge.
六层是这个色、声、香、味。
Yeah, so the six roots are the different sensory orifices. The six types of dust are flavor, touch, looking at things, smelling, and color, and a sound.
就是讲这些茶叶的色香味就是通过楼根楼层楼丝来把它结合起来茶叶的品质就出来了品茶就是我们用客观的标准去衡量一种茶叶这叫做品茶用客观的标准国家标准或许是什么不标班标准或许是传统产品的规格标准来衡量这个茶是不是好就是品茶
什么样的标准 So the way how you grade and evaluate the quality of tea is always according to a certain standard.You know, like according to what the government sets as a standard now or what there was a traditional craftsmanship standard. And it always involves, and that's why he was quoting the six roots of Buddhism, your sensory, your senses. You evaluate with your senses.
我们中国品茶是个很规范的事情。
Very much like, and I'm adding that, like the evaluation of good wine in France is a big deal and gets taken very seriously, and you literally go to university to become a sommelier, etc. This kind of job of evaluating and grading tea is a big deal in China.
每年都有举行部一级的、国家一级的、部一级的、省一级的评比会。
Every year, you've got competitions on the national level, on the province level, and on the local level.
我有幸成为国家的农业部、商业部、外贸部三个部的评委，每年参加评比。
So every year, he is being invited as one of the, you know, on all three levels, he gets invited as an evaluator to evaluate particularly important types of tea.
因此，我们国家每年都有一些部优产品，或许是国优产品，或许部优产品，或许省优产品。这些产品。 第一个是代表我们受清整茶叶上万家产家的最好的水平。
So every year, among all of the different types of tea, there will be chosen the best ones that represent their category.
品茶，品茶，就是在一定的环境下面。 一定的气氛下面，几个朋友共同来品评这个茶的优缺点、好坏。So
品茶, the sampling of the tea, is more of a private matter, where you—that's what we're doing right now. You get together, sit around the table with a couple of friends, and then you try different teas, and everybody. Gives their 5 cents worth and their poetic, personal, subjective evaluation of what that tea makes them feel like.
它不带功利性，它不带什么，它代表一些我们自己的爱好，它没有什么很多这个强制性的标准。
So the difference between the first category, 品茶, and the second category, 品茶, is that the first one is a very serious business with very strict standards that are measurable, and the second one is a subjective personal business that's very poetic, where there's anything goes. You know, people just sitting around and uttering sounds and uttering poetic descriptions of the blackberry notes and the tea, or something like that.
像我们这样的一个优美的环境，这么多朋友在一起啊，这个随便喝喝茶，这个茶怎么样，好不好？
So this is a typical
很舒服，很愉快。平茶
event here, where we're all sitting around.
很友谊，不带硬核。
Yes, so this is, we're just hanging out here having a good time, that's 品茶.
心情很平淡。这就是一个很好的增进友谊的、增进和谐的一种气氛。
This type of atmosphere has been cultivated in China for a long time, is celebrating friendship through communally drinking tea.
这个品茶的时候，在我们国家是种很修行的。
This is, he used the word, he said drinking tea is the epitome of Xiuxian, which is sort of like the free and easy wanderer, having a good time, kick back and relax. That's what is associated with tea.
有的时候，在一些地区，他们把这个品茶看成是一种友谊的比赛。你比如说，我这里有一泡茶，哎呀，这泡我这里有泡好茶，大家喝一喝。喝了以后，他等一下又拉一包出来，我这里更有一包好的，你们再试试。好，他又拉一包出来，他这样呢，一个上午就喝完了。这个大家很愉快，心情很愉快。
It's one of the greatest joys of the tea connoisseur to get together with his friends, and in some areas of China, it's almost like sort of a friendly competition where one person pulls out a little piece of tea out of the pocket and says, I've got this really special 40-year-old stuff, and let's try that. And then the next person says, I've got, this is really good, but I've got something even better. And so that's, yeah.
有的也把它看成一种地位性的这个标志，有的他是一个茶王，他袋子里那个茶一定是个非常好的茶，这个就表示他在茶盖有地位。
So there is also, you know, for people who professionally deal with tea.It's like a serious competition. You don't want to be outshined by somebody bringing a better tea to the table. So he said if Dr. Liu here is our tea king, and he's known for that, he wants to bring his best tea to the table. Otherwise, he's going to lose face.
有可能的话就是简单的看还有
什么问题没有
就他们可能还有这么个问题就是这个绿茶和黑茶和红茶这个区别到底是什么除了那个颜色以外是在栽培的时候的区别还是长在什么地方
红茶、绿茶、黑茶，这三种茶都是同一株茶树上面长出来的，都是同样的新叶。
I said one question that most of us have, I know that I do have that, is what is the exact difference between a green tea, a red tea, and a black tea, etc. He says the green tea.The red tea and the black tea all originate from the same plant, the same kind of tea bush.
红茶呢，是首先叶子采回来以后，新叶采回来以后，通过萎凋。
So the 红茶, the red tea, after it's been harvested, undergoes a process of, How do you call that when you have vegetables and you put them in a vegetable dryer? That it's called dehydrate. Yes, it undergoes a process of dehydration.
第二个就是油碾，萎掉以后就油碾。
揉。
And after that, 就用手工去揉。
手工有机器。
Yeah. Originally, then you would soften the tea like this. You would massage the tea, make it softer and softer. Nowadays, you use machines for that process.
然后再去发酵。
Afterwards, it undergoes a process of fermentation.
发酵的时候。是里面的茶多酚变成茶黄瘦茶红瘦于是叶子就变红了
And in that process of fermentation, which is most likely you know, I think you put a wet blanket actually over the tea, then for a certain period of time, then the greenness of the tea will turn into redness.
再把它干燥就变成了红茶。
After you dry that material, it will turn into what then is called 红茶 red tea. 那么发酵多长时间平均？
发酵两个小时左右。
1 to 2 hours, that's how long the fermentation process lasts, which is a relatively short period of time. Pu'er, for instance, you have like several weeks for the cooked, the fermented version of the pu'er.
红茶的品质特征叫做红叶红汤。
There are two different types.Of red tea, they call 红叶红汤
汤
汤
汤哦红汤红叶红汤
对这个绿茶就是鲜叶采回来以后到炒锅子里面去杀青
The 绿茶 the green tea is you take the fresh tea leaves and you fry them briefly in a dryfry them in a wok until sort of the green color comes out even more.
把叶子里面的一种酶把它冻化就不会起氧化作用叶子就不红了于是就变成绿色。
You destroy in that process, in the dry walking process, a certain enzyme in the leaf that will prevent the green tea from oxidizing.
再把椰子杀青以后，再把椰子把它揉成条索，一条条。
Afterwards, you take the leaves which are flat, you roll them, also traditionally by hand, into little pipe-like structures.
把它干燥就变成绿茶。
Then you dry it, and then you've got what's called 绿茶 green tea.
绿茶的特点是绿叶绿汤。
The just like the characteristic of the red tea was red leaves and red decoction, the specialty of the characteristic of the green tea is the leaves are green and the steeped water that comes from it is green as well.
黑茶是这样的。
The black tea, 黑茶，
新叶采回来以后杀青油腻。
So the black tea is you also fry the leaves at high, dry fry them at high temperature and you also massage them with your hands.
揉好以后把那么一坨坨的茶堆积起来叫做窝堆。
And then you put the leaves together, the soft leaves together in a big heap, that's called 窝堆。
四个小时十二个小时。
十个小时到十二个小时 and you leave it in a heap, presumably to ferment for 10 to 12 hours.
再把它干燥
and then afterwards you dry it.
于是变成黑茶
then you've got what's called 黑茶 black tea.
黑茶的特点，黑茶它比较红茶、绿茶都要稍微成熟一些，稍微老一点，粗一点。
So the characteristic of the black tea is that in comparison to the green tea anyway, but to the red tea is that it's darker and has a sort of a more musky flavor to it because the fermentation time is
有股很强的
5 to 10 times as long.
有种很强的
And you have a fairly strongfermentation flavor to the tea.
它的汤色是橙黄，就是像这种。
The color what we're drinking is black tea here. Its color is sort of a darker type of yellow.
你像我们是圣居威的这种砖茶，就是把这种茶再然后再去进行再一次发酵，再一次蒸，然后压制，再干燥，就变成 这种砖茶。
The,
这种砖茶的汤色就比这个汤色要深。
The black tea is also a different way of processing it, that you take the process after this process that we just described, which would be loose black tea. You can also press it into bricks where you would ferment it further and then steam it and press it, presumably in modern times with a machine, into a brick, and that is what you have in your bags as a present here.
Huang cha.
The yellow tea, huang cha.
Huang cha is 新叶采回来以后杀青，杀青以后就把它焖黄。
So the so-called yellow tea, you take the same materials also, of the, you dry fry it at high heat, and then you leave the leaves in the pot, and you put the lid on and leave it in there for several hours.
这个银河油凝干燥，黄茶的汤色是黄的。
So that helps then to dry out the tea leaves and gives a yellow quality to the tea once it's steeped or decocted.
再有一个白茶。
The white kind of tea, 白茶。
这个白茶是新叶采回来以后就换了阴凉的地方跟它阴干。萎凋干燥一次阴干。
This is 就没有杀青，
没有
杀青
哈。哎，没有杀青。
So that is the white kind of tea does not undergo the quick fry process. You just right after the harvest you put it in a dark cool place to let it dry there.
它的汤色是带那个淡绿色
，the color
黄绿色。
Of the steeped tea is translucent with maybe a little bit of a green sheen to it.
So, you don't have to think that six drinks are six drinks made of green tea.
So, don't think that the six types of teas, the black tea and the red tea and the green tea and the white tea, come from six different species of plants.They are simply they all come from the same plant, from the same kind of tea bush, Camellia sinensis, that is processed in different ways.